Let's first talk about the big development that has taken place when it comes to the Supreme Court. The two-judge Supreme Court bench of Justice Suryakant and Justice Nguyen, who has now granted conditional bail to the Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal in the CBI case linked to Liquorgate investigation. He was formally arrested by the CBI on the 26th of June when he was already in the custody of the Enforcement Directorate. Now, the Supreme Court today granted him bail, but has also upheld the arrest that was made by the CBI, calling it not illegal. While the Aam Aadmi Party camp is already celebrating and hailing the verdict with sweets and dholes and loudly chanting Satyameva Jayate, it is also important to mention that when Arvind Kejriwal walks out of jail, probably this evening, he still will not have the authority to perform the duties as the chief minister. As per the bail conditions, Arvind Kejriwal cannot visit the secretariat. He cannot sign official files. He cannot publicly make comments about the case. He cannot even access official files related to the case. And he strictly cannot interact with any witnesses in the case. Let me straight away go across to Harish. Now, Harish, good afternoon. Auto copy that has been accessed as well. The key highlights, the takeaways, of course, when it comes to pulling up the investigative agencies as well, that has also been done by the Supreme Court.
Yes, that's right, Amita. In fact, this job has been done by Justice Ujjwal Nguyen. Though he had concurred with Justice Suryakant as far as grant of bail to Kejriwal and also declaring the arrest by CBI as saying that no procedural error has been committed in the arrest of Kejriwal. At the same time, as you rightly said, Amita, Ujjwal Nguyen has pulled up the CBI saying that it's high time CBI regain its independent image and shed its image as a caged parrot, which the Supreme Court had called it a few years ago during the UPA regime, saying that the probe conducted by CBI should be fair, transparent, and inspiring confidence in the general public. This, Justice Ujjwal Nguyen said while questioning the necessity and timing of the arrest of Kejriwal, saying that he found merit in the argument of Abhishek Manu Singhvi, who had appeared for Kejriwal, which said that it is nothing but an insurance arrest to ensure that Kejriwal does not come out after he had secured bail in the bail from the Supreme Court in the ED case. Justice Ujjwal Nguyen said that it's very clear that CBI wanted to ensure that he continued to be in jail after he got bail. Three release orders, one initially from the Supreme Court in the very stringent, under stringent PMLA, interim bail to campaign, then a regular bail from the lower court, and also interim bail from the Supreme Court. Apart from that, the other takeaway is that, yes, it's a big relief for Arvind Kejriwal because the concurrent opinion of the two judges that he shall be released on bail. Basically, the principle in the bail granted to Sanjay Singh, Manish Sisodia, K. Kavita has been applied in this case, basically ruling that bail is the norm and jail is an exception. Also, consider the fact that
they have been saying when it comes to all of the leaders who were indicted, who were jailed on part of the ongoing Liquorgate investigation, are out on bail. We also talk about how the Aam Aadmi Party has been hailing the bail that has been granted by India's apex court, starting right from Mrs. Sunita Kejriwal, who has been hitting after the BJP right after the verdict of Avaba, has been also seen distributing sweets at the residence in civil lines.
भाजपा के मंसूबों पे पानी फिर गया. वो लोग विपक्ष के नेताओं को जेल में डाल के सत्ता में बने रहना चाहते हैं. उनका मकसद ये है.
आज माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने भारतीय जनता पार्टी को भी एक बहुत बड़ा संदेश दिया है कि तुम्हें अपनी तानाशाही बंद करनी पड़ेगी. आज माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट का आदेश भारतीय जनता पार्टी के मुंह पे एक कड़ा तमाचा है कि आप एजेंसियों का दुरुपयोग कर रहे हो. आपने एजेंसियों को अपना केज पैरेट बना के रखा हुआ है. ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने बहुत साफ शब्दों में कहा कि सीबीआई केज पैरेट की तरह से काम कर रही है. देश के आम आदमी को ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट का साफ संदेश है, साफ भरोसा है कि आप चिंता मत करो. अगर कोई तानाशाही चलाएगा, अगर कोई एजेंसियों का दुरुपयोग करेगा, तो देश का संविधान उसकी रक्षा के लिए है.
आज भी सीबीआई एक पिंजरे में कैद तोते की तरह है जिसको आजाद करने की जरूरत है। तो आज तो मौका है कि देश के गृह मंत्री जो सीधे सीबीआई को संभालते हैं वो देश को इसके बारे में जवाब दें कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने जो कहा है उसके बारे में उनको क्या कहना। बीजेपी ने पहले दिन से ये कहा और मैं दोहरा देता हूँ, बीजेपी के एक एक प्रवक्ता ने पहले दिन से ये कहा कि अगर कुछ नहीं किया तो बेल क्यों नहीं मिल रही है, बेल क्यों नहीं मिल रही है, बेल क्यों नहीं मिल रही है। तो भैया बेल मिल गई, मिल गई, मिल गई। अब वो तर्क और कुतर्क खत्म हो गए।
आम आदमी पार्टी को और ताकत मिलेगी और पार्टी का एक कार्यकर्ता होने के नाते दिल्ली का एक दिल्ली और पंजाब और पूरे देश भर का एक नागरिक होने के नाते मैं तहे दिल से स्वागत करता हूँ इस फैसले का। और बस एक ही चीज़ कहना चाहता हूँ इस भावुक लम्हे में कि वेलकम बैक अरविंद केजरीवाल।
All right, with those reactions coming on part of the Aam Aadmi Party as they have been hailing the verdict, we also talk about how the BJP has been reacting right after the bail was granted by the Supreme Court. Within few hours, the BJP holding a press briefing saying that this is nothing, this is not a clean chit, this is not an acquittal. However, the jail wala CM has now become the bail wala CM.
और ये कहना गलत नहीं होगा, जेल वाला सीएम अब बेल वाला सीएम हो गया है। अरविंद केजरीवाल को तुरंत चाहिए कि वो अपने पद से इस्तीफा दे दे, लेकिन बेशरम अरविंद केजरीवाल ऐसा करेंगे नहीं, क्योंकि अरविंद केजरीवाल में एक बूंद नैतिकता नहीं बची है।
एक आरोपी बेल पर बाहर आ रहा है, वो दिल्ली का दोषी है, वो दिल्ली का अपराधी है, अपराध उन्होंने दिल्ली के साथ किया है, लेकिन कोर्ट कहती है कि आप मुख्यमंत्री के रूप में कोई फाइल साइन नहीं कर सकते, ऑफिस नहीं जा सकते, जब कुछ कर नहीं सकते तो इस्तीफा दो, किसी और को लाओ। दिल्ली को इतना तकलीफ दे दिया है, कितनी तकलीफें और देंगे अरविंद केजरीवाल आप दिल्ली को।
जो लोग अभी सत्य की जीत हुई है, सत्य जो है वो जो है परेशान हो सकता है, पराजित नहीं हो सकता, ये घिसी पिटी जो नारे देते हैं, उन्हें ये पहले तय करना चाहिए कि कब सत्य की हार होती है और कब सत्य की जीत होती है, ये तय कर लें अपनी सुविधा के अनुसार। सत्य की हार और जीत अगर ये गढ़ेंगे तो मुझे नहीं लगता कि इनको कोई फायदा होगा। कोई भी जमानत उस किसी भी गुनाहगार या किसी भी अपराधी या किसी भी आरोपी के दोषमुक्त होने का प्रमाण पत्र नहीं होता।
Tejri is with us right now. Tejri, good afternoon. Reactions coming in thick and fast. However, when it comes to the chief minister now being granted bail, but when it comes to his powers to exercise, as the chief minister is concerned, however, that has been put on conditions on part of the Supreme Court while granting bail.
Absolutely, that seems to be a big hurdle or problem for Aam Aadmi Party, because even if politically they are gaining, they will gain strong, they will get strong politically, but as far as the powers are concerned, yes, they are restricted, because certainly Arvind Kejriwal, the Chief Minister of Delhi, will not be able to go to his own office. He will not be able to go to the Chief Secretariat. And in fact, he will not be able to sign the important files also. So now if Arvind Kejriwal is not able to, will not be able to sign important files, how will the tenders be passed? How will the new policies will be implemented? How will the ministers be nominated? Or apart from that, the most important question, how once again the new deputy chief minister will be nominated or will be elected. So these are all the questions that will remain as it is. But what Aam Aadmi Party responds to these all questions is that yes, this is they will be abiding with the law. They will be working according to what the conditions that have been mentioned by the court. But this thing that, but they feel that this is a big win for the party, no matter what, even if it is with the restriction. But yes, we'll have to see that what happens next, how will the government function, because even if there is some important file that Arvind Kejriwal has to sign, then certainly he will have to take approval from the Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, V.K. Right. Saxena, then only he can find the file. So yes, we'll have to see what happens next, Aam Aadmi Party, and what is there for the people, and how Aam Aadmi Party will be campaigning for Delhi and Haryana as well.
All right, be on the lookout for that, because this is coming across as a big development as far as bail being granted to Arvind Kejriwal right before the elections are to take place, at least in Haryana. But we also talk about how when it comes to the celebrations that have been taking place, of course, but the Aam Aadmi Party, which is now feeling a sense of sukoon. There are dholes, there are celebrations, there are sweets that are being distributed, triumphantly declaring the victory of truth. Sattameh Jayate is what they have been saying. Aam Aadmi Party karyakartas putting up posters saying that when it comes to Arvind Kejriwal, Modi tera ek hi kaal, desh ka lal Arvind Kejriwal. Now, the chanting of slogans that is also being done and the chorus that has also been growing within the India Bloc allies as well, because they are celebrating this win, and they have been saying that they stand vindicated when they say that central agencies are being misused against the opposition leaders.
This has come as a relief, and the Supreme Court had given a lesson to the BJP government. They are misusing all their agencies, be it ED or be it CBI, whatever agencies they have under their control, they are misusing them against the opposition party leaders. Bail is a right of the accused. He is still an accused. He is not a convicted. He is an accused. The ED and CBI had to prove their case. So far, I don't know what steps they have taken to prove that case. Why should he be suffering in the prison? He is a chief minister, he is a party leader. Unnecessarily, they have put him in jail.
पहले हेमंत सोरेन जी हमारे झारखंड के गठबंधन के मुख्यमंत्री को जमानत, और अब अरविंद केजरीवाल जी को भी जमानत मिल गई है. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उनको ये पाया है कि ये केस जमानत के योग्य है. जन्नाटेदार करारा तमाचा है ये मोदी सरकार पर, जो अपने जो राष्ट्रीय एजेंसियां हैं जांच की, उनका दुरुपयोग एक फ्रंटल संगठन के तौर पर करके